whenever we come to display of data, there is a fundamental rule called the area principle. Now, what does this area principle actually tell us? When we look at the area principle states that the area occupied by a part of the graph should correspond to the amount of data it represents. What do we mean by this? You can look at the first thing is, when I have charts which are decorated to attract attention. For example, let's look at this particular chart. Now, what this chart gives us is the total wine exports in the United States value in millions of dollars. Now, this is more like an infographic, but what does this tell? It tells us United Kingdom is about 150.3, Canada is 146.8, Japan is 82.8, Italy is 42.5 and Netherlands is 34.4. You can immediately see that there is no baseline. It shows bottles on top of the labeled boxes. Now, even the boxes are not of any uniform shape. There are various shapes and sizes. So, when you look at this chart, it does not convey anything which is actually I can make a meaning out of. Whatever I need to convey is just the total US wine exports to each one of these countries. And I can construct this using a bar chart where my categories are again United Kingdom, Canada, Japan, Italy and Netherlands. I have labeled each one of my categories. I can see that United Kingdom has a value in $150.3 million. Canada is about $146.8 million, 82.8 to Japan, 42.5 to Italy and 34.4 to Netherlands. Now, the chart on the right hand side obeys what we call the area principle. It is accurate. It has a baseline. This is the baseline of this chart. So, you can see that this is the baseline of this chart. It has and everything is, it is actually consistent. The width of the bars for each country is equal and I can have a vertical scale, and on the vertical scale I have the value which is given, and hence it obeys what I refer to as the area principle, where the area occupied by the graph, and what is the area occupied by the graph? It is this area, it is this area, it is this area, it is this area, and this area, it is proportional to the data that is being presented. The next way people mislead with graphs is through use of what we call as truncated graphs. Now, what is a truncated graph? Now, let me show. One thing is where the baseline of a bar chart is not at 0. What do we mean by baseline of a bar chart is not at 0? Now, let me show you this graph. Now, again this is a regional wise distribution. I have 4 regions, south, west, north and east. Now, when I portray this data and this graph to you, you can immediately see there are 500 people. And I have just, the data is which region do these 500 people come from, that is the data. Now, when I portray or I show this graph, the immediate thing or the immediate response for a person who looks at this data without looking at the axis is to imagine that this people from south and north are much higher than the people from west or east. That is what this message, this graph conveys. But when we look more carefully at the data, you see that this is the baseline and it starts at 0, whereas here it starts at 75. Now, these two graphs are actually the same data. What do I mean by same data? 500 students, each one of them tell which state region they come from, whether it is the south, whether it is the west, whether it is the north or the east. when you look at this graph, you feel that the south and north are the ones from where majority of the students come. Even though majority come, it seems that the north and east are negligible to the distribution from north and south, whereas this graph conveys a different story. So, the left graph or this graph exaggerates the number, whereas this graph shows the same with baseline at 0. Now, this is what is recommended, because this is where data integrity is maintained and the actual story is said. Now, where does this matter? Now, when you are showing a growth and everything and you truncate the graph or you misrepresent data or you mislead, people will actually attribute a wrong story to this, even though both of them represent the same data. Visually you see that this tells a different story than what the one on the right says. So, the second thing is, whenever you truncate graph, there is a loss in information and it is a violation. This has to be avoided. Now, some textbooks and some people say that whenever you have a truncated graph or something, you introduce a y-axis break. So, if you are starting and you are breaking the axis, you can introduce it either by doing this, where I am telling that I am introducing a break in my y-axis, or you can show that this is, I am not starting from 0, there is a break and I am starting from a higher value. For example, if I wanted to start from 75, I should have indicated that I am starting from 75 instead of shifting the graph to 75. So, this is incorrect, whereas this is the right way to go about it. So, whenever you are altering or manipulating with the y-axis, indicate to the reader that you have manipulated or you have introduced a y-axis break.